7 image ideas for writers and bloggers. Now, even though I have put that title on this video, you can use it for any part of your business or anybody who is outside those two things. I just needed to put a title on the video today, and that's why it settled on that one. But if you're a car mechanic, if you're anybody at all, you can simply use this as well too in your business. Now, as you're probably well aware, social media is a huge beast that you just can't feed. It's almost like a long kind of conveyor belt. You put your content on today, and a couple of hours from now, it disappears off the newsfeed. If you're lucky, you might get maybe a couple of days out of a piece of content on maybe a slow moving newsfeed or whatever, depending on the platform that you're on. But as you're probably well aware, whatever content you put up today is probably gone tomorrow. Nobody's going to see it unless maybe they land maybe on a Facebook page and they purposely scroll back through the content to find out what you've been posting. And it's only then that that content will be seen. But for the majority of times, it's almost like the tip of the iceberg is the only thing that's seen. All the other content you have done in the past has simply just disappeared, never to be seen again. So if you are looking for content ideas for social media, you're probably well aware that images are probably one of the most eye-catching. You know, it's okay to put maybe a small piece of text on Twitter or something like that, but as you're probably well aware, when you're scrolling through Twitter, what really catches your eyes? It's the images and it's the videos. The text is very, very easy to scroll past, unless maybe you are taking your time and maybe you are following somebody that you want to know, you know, what they're actually saying or talking about. That's the only time you would simply just slow down and actually read that text. But in the majority of cases, you're probably just scrolling with your thumb, either through Instagram or Facebook or whatever, and it's only maybe when an image catches your eye that you'll actually stop and take a look at it for a second, and then you might read maybe the text, or then you might click on the link. So you're going to need image content. So as I said, because it is something that you need to do regularly, you're going to run out of ideas, and that is why I'm putting this video together, this podcast episode. I'm going to show you 7 ways you can come up with content. Now, I have written them down on a piece of paper just so I don't forget. So the first one is, quotations. Now, a lot of people will repost quotations from Einstein or from some celebrity or all those different people. You've seen the same quotes again and again and again. Somebody will take something that somebody had said years ago, some genius or whatever, and they will post it on their wall. But why bother doing that, you know? Why bother giving that Einstein or whatever, you know, a place on your wall? Because the majority of times those real quotes aren't, they're trying to make you look clever, but are they really relevant to you and your business? Wouldn't it be better if you actually put quotes of your own up on your wall? Now, this is something that I've always done, and I could never really understand that in my head. Why would I give space on my social media wall to other people's quotes? Why can't I come up with my own? Now, you will find, if you do follow some people, you will find maybe some quotes that motivate you and that you can repurpose and, you know, put on the wall to motivate your followers. But in the majority of cases, I would use my own quotations, because you will find sometimes when you write maybe a blog post, even a piece of fiction or something like that, as you're writing, you'll probably stop for a second and some character might say something really profound, and you'll actually look at it and you'll say, did I actually write that down, or where did that come from? And I have done that many times when I got lost in fiction, lost in a character, and my mind was just throwing out the words and I was just quickly typing, trying to keep up with that character. That character might say something profound and it would stop me in my tracks again, as I said, and I would look at the words and I'd say, did I really write that, or where did that come from? And sometimes your characters actually can give you profound. Now, if you aren't into fiction writing, that probably sounds like the craziest thing ever. Somebody is having an imaginary conversation in your head and you have no real control over it. And, you know, you are getting something profound. But it's actually you had to come up with it. But it's not you that actually came up with that quote, if you get my feel, if you get my drift. But as I said, sometimes you will look back in your work, even a blog post. Sometimes you will summarize something down into a really concise point that will really, really explain something to somebody. So rather than you putting on some quote by some genius or some celebrity or a movie star or some, you know, like The Rock or Arnold Schwarzenegger said this or all those different things, ditch all that. Why not do your own quotations? Put something fresh up that's unique to you. So when somebody's going through your newsfeed and they're actually seeing quotations by you, you know, that kind of lifts you up in their eyes. They're going to say, well, this person has a brain in their head. They actually have something clever to say here, you know, and it's going to lift you up rather than you giving the time and highlighting some other genius's quotation. So give that a thought. Again, when it comes to quotations, it doesn't even need to be your quotations. Again, as I said, if you are a fiction writer, there might be maybe a quote that one of your characters has said that has really, really stood out. So why not just take that piece of text out of it? Again, give your character the full credit for that quotation, and then have maybe a link at the bottom of that image or a link to where that book is that that character's in. So for example, maybe if I had maybe a thriller book, like a kind of Jason Bourne thing or some kind of thriller thing or something like that, if my character said something profound, I could have that quotation on the thing, on the image, and then a link to where somebody could actually buy the book to find out more about that character or what's going on or why is he actually saying that thing. Again, you could use maybe romance quotes if you have maybe a romance book, something that maybe your female character has said that maybe you've got to do with love or romance or something like that. Again, dress that up with a nice kind of romantic background, put the quotation on it, put your character's name on it, and then a link to maybe where the book is or your blog or something like that. So if you feel maybe, you know, you could do that, either give yourself credit for the quotation or give your character credit for the quotation, because you will find that probably will intrigue somebody saying, well, I've never heard of this person before, and you know, they might click on that image and go over and have a look at that book. So that could be one way you could actually do the quotations. Instead of posting everybody else's quotations, start coming up with your own, or start posting your character's quotations. Now again, back to the piece of paper. The next one is passages from your book. Now again, as I said, you could use a quote from one of your characters, but maybe if you had a dramatic scene or something like that, you had a bit of a cliffhanger, could you grab maybe a small paragraph of that and end it on a cliffhanger? You can imagine if you were scrolling through a newsfeed and you came upon some bit of action that stopped and froze for a second, even if maybe it was something dramatic, like for example maybe there's a bomb counting down or something like that, and something is just about to happen and you just simply switch off and you just cut them off at that point when that person's reading that piece. Now, if you do it really, really well, you can get up the curiosity. You're probably going to say, well, what the hell happens next, or where did that come from, or where can I find out more about this? Again, have that on a piece, an image, something attractive that is relevant to your book's theme, and then have a link to where that book is. So try and maybe just cut a romantic quotation. Again, like a quote about love or something like that, or something that your character's made, or a kind of cut-off point in action that is going to intrigue that person when they're actually looking at that image, and that might force them, get their curiosity going, that they actually click on that image and go over and have a look at what is going on that book. Now, the next one we are looking at is you at work. Now, I don't know about you, but me being a fan of a writer or a blogger or maybe a YouTuber, sometimes we get more enjoyment. It's like, you used to find sometimes in the early days, well, they probably still do, but in the early days before the internet and all that, one of the TV shows I used to love watching was where they would maybe go behind the scenes of a big movie. Now, in the early days, like most kids, I was a huge Star Wars fan. So if there was a TV show that was going to take you behind the scenes of how maybe Jim Henson did Yoda, how they created, you know, the stormtroopers or the spaceships and all those different things, I was straight into it, and I would love to know what was going on in the background. You know, I'd seen what the movie was like, but how did they actually get to that point? How did they get to create those spaceships? How does Yoda move and talk and all those different things? And it was only when I watched a TV show that I found out how I did it, how all the things went on in the background. Now, if you have readers, if they do enjoy following you and enjoy reading your content, there is a good chance that they would actually want to look behind the curtain. They want to actually see what goes on. How do you come up with your ideas? You know, for example, if there is somebody maybe who is watching these videos and would like to know more about these videos, I could put a couple of screenshots up of the field that I'm walking around in right now. I could take a couple of screenshots of my bare feet walking through this wet field. I could show you all the different things that are going on in the background. I could show you pictures of my dog who's walking along with me at the moment. But I could show you all the things that you can't actually see right now that are going on in the background. And again, if you are somebody who likes following me, likes watching these videos, that might interest you. So why not come up with some of those behind the scenes content ideas for your book? For example, you know, something simple like maybe you could have been at a coffee shop today. You might have got the great, you know, a storyline in your head as you were having a cup of coffee at Starbucks, and you quickly wrote it down on a napkin. Now, you could just take a photograph of that bare bones of a storyline, and you could say, you know, this is behind the scenes. This is how this book you're reading right now, or the book you read 6 months ago, this was it on the very, very first day. This is how it started. Or you could do maybe a couple of sketches of what your character looks like. You know, if it is, again, a fiction book, you know, what does your character look like? What do they dress? Maybe you have done a couple of hand-drawn sketches, or maybe you might be somebody who works with real photographs. Maybe you might do maybe a Google search to find out, you know, what kind of dress did they wear back in medieval times, or what kind of armor did the knights wear in your book. You can simply have a couple of screenshots of maybe those Google searches that you had done to come up with your book. So again, what goes on behind the scenes doesn't even necessarily need to be about your book. Even a couple of screenshots of your desk, you know, your workstation. What is on your workstation? Again, it could be you might have a quirky cup. You may wear some t-shirt that you find comfortable to write in. All those different things that your reader would be really, really interested in, that they're never going to see on the other side. They are just going to see the books. But you could go in talking about what goes on in the background. You know, what do you do every day? And by letting them behind the curtain, it's going to build a stronger bond between you and your reader, because they're going to see more about you. They're going to have more of a rapport. And when it comes to those books that you have written, they're not going to look at it as just a book. They're going to see that maybe that storyline written down on a napkin. They're going to see all those Google image searches that you did. They're going to see you working at that workstation, typing away on that keyboard. All those different things are going to play in your head. And because you have given them all those different things, it gives them a more rounded view of you as an author. And it can really, really help give you content ideas for your stream. So think about that, you know. Give your reader a look behind the scenes. What goes on that they're not aware of? Again, think along the same lines of those TV shows that will take you behind the scenes and show you all the special effects or all the things that you're not aware of. Now, another thing you can do too is do some social media images of maybe fans with your work. Now, if you have somebody maybe who sends in a photograph of them holding your book, that's perfect. You can just use that as it is, and you can just mention on your social media platform, here is one of my happy fans with one of my books. And again, give them a big shout out, because if they are fans of yours, they would love for you to single them out. They would love you to, you know, to kind of put them on a pedestal for the day and say, you know, this is one of my fans with my work. I'm sure it would make their day. If you imagine if you were a big Stephen King fan and Stephen King all of a sudden pulled you from obscurity, took your image of you holding his book and put it on a social media feed, you know, how chuffed would you be for that to happen? So if you have some fans, why not ask them if they could take photographs, you know, of your book or your work, even in some weird places. If you want to make a competition out of it, what is the weirdest place you have read one of my books, or what's the weirdest place maybe you have, you know, studied one of my training courses or whatever. Get them to send all that image content into you. And then you can, again, with their permission, put it on your social media feed. And that is one of the easiest ways of coming up with content ideas, because you don't actually need to do the work. They are taking the photographs and they are giving you content that you simply just need to repost, and that is it. So that's one thing you could do. Another thing then too is, even yourself, if you are doing any writings or any public appearances, maybe if you were given a talk, or maybe if you had, you know, a recent book release, maybe you're releasing something in your local bookstore, or you were doing some kind of book promotion, whether that's a talk in front of fans, or whether that could be maybe a virtual summit or something like that you're speaking at, or a Zoom call or something like that where you are promoting a book. Again, it could be maybe you could be featured on somebody's podcast, or you might be on somebody's blog or whatever, as a guest post. But maybe if you are doing some kind of promotion work for your books, or you're doing some book signings or something like that, but you're actually reaching out and meeting fans, record all that. Try and take as many pictures as you can, even screenshots or whatever. Again, get permission from everybody to use it, but use those as your social media content for that day. Now, Another thing then too is you and your pet. Now, as you're probably well aware, I'm not walking around this field on my own. I have my black and white border collie that I'm walking around with Summer. So a few people know that I have a dog, and from time to time I take snapshots of Summer. So why don't you, again, like looking behind the scenes, take some snapshots and give your pet, you know, give them the highlight or the kind of the spotlight on your social media account, maybe for a day or two. It doesn't always have to be about you. And again, you're letting the fans and everything have a look behind the curtain of what goes on in your daily life. And your pets are another part of your daily life. And who doesn't want to look at a cute pet that maybe has a cute costume on it, or who could be lying, you know, with their mouth open, kind of half asleep, or all those kind of funny images. We have seen them all over Reddit and everywhere else. So why don't you maybe take a couple of shots of your dog doing goofy things? And you know what, you could use it maybe as a promotional thing. You could throw maybe a copy of your book beside them or whatever, just so it gets captured in the snapshot. Again, so not only are you getting attention on your dog, but you could also use it as a simple promotion, you know, exercise as well too. So have a look at your pets. What daft things your pets do, are they cute or whatever? Take some shots of them and put them on your social media platform as well too, to get eyeballs on your work. Again, as I said, it's very easy to get stopped by a kitten or a dog or something funny on news feed. So that could be one way that you could stop somebody in their tracks today, by having some cute shots of your pets on it. Now, another thing then too is to, I think that is everything I'd mentioned you at work. Yeah, the last thing then would be days of the year. Now, a website that I use from time to time when I'm stuck for ideas is one called daysoftheyear.com. Now, this isn't your average website where it'll show you maybe the public holidays or the bank holidays. What it does is you will find that there are actually a lot of weird and wonderful holidays from time to time. For example, if you go over there, you will actually find that there's a Mickey Mouse Day, there probably is a Peanut Butter Day, there probably is a Pizza Day, there probably is a Jelly Baby Day or a Gummy Bear Day, or all those kind of weird and wonderful things. Or what else could they be? Maybe, well, they already know, like probably Teacher's Day, but there could be something like a Fireman Day, there could be something like a Clown Day, all those different things. So if you go over to daysoftheyear.com, have a look and see what is coming up in the next couple of days or weeks or month, and see if you could, you know, grab onto one of those holidays and use it as inspiration for your social media image. Again, you know, if it is something like to do with peanut butter, you could talk about your big love of peanut butter and maybe have a couple of shots of you, you know, buttering up a peanut butter sandwich or doing something daft with peanut butter. Like, for example, I seen recently there was a lady who was clipping the nails on her dog, and what she would do to get her dog to stay in the one position was to wrap cling film all around her forehead and her head so it's completely covered, and then she would smear her forehead in peanut butter. So as the dog is actually licking the peanut butter off her head and is totally distracted, she is snipping away at his toenails because he doesn't realize what's going on. He's too busy licking the peanut butter off her forehead. So could you come up with something daft or wonderful like that that could make people laugh? And again, it could be maybe part of that day. You could use maybe the hashtag peanut butter day or whatever it is, and you never know, you might get some momentum out of that if other people are using it or searching on Google or on Twitter or whatever on that day for the peanut butter day or whatever it is. So you never know where your image could show up. So have a look at that website also, days of the year. Is there some way you could, not only you, again, you can go back to your pet, could you dress up your pet maybe as the team of the day or whatever? You know, it's very easy to find costumes nowadays for cats and dogs, or some kind of props that you can put around them, and you can make a cute and funny video, and that could be your content for the day. As I said at the very start, you know, these ideas don't have to be just solely used by authors or bloggers. Anyone can do it. Anyone with a business who is looking for image content, is looking for some way of stopping people in their tracks. As I said, you know, image content, all the content on the social media platforms, they don't last there very long. They're just there for a couple of hours, if you're lucky, or days, but rarely, as I said, days you will find the content will be there. If people want to find that content, they will have to search it out, go back through maybe a Facebook page to find it. So as you are constantly coming up with ideas and needing more and more ideas, so give those ideas a day. Grab a pen and paper. If you need to go back through this episode, you know, pause it every so often, take a couple of notes, but I'm sure you're going to find tons of ideas for coming up with social media images this week. So If you'd like to ask me any questions and you'd like me to cover something in an upcoming video, you're very welcome to reach out to barryjmcdonald@gmail.com. Or if you'd like to know more about these videos and podcast episodes, where are they? Where can I find them? How can I find out more about this site? Again, do a search for WriteCome, that's WriteCome.com. Now, if you go over to the main site today, that's WriteCome.com, you'll find we have a great free report on it, and it's called Words to Wealth. And in it, I'm going to show you 10 ways anyone can make money from their keyboard. Now, you're probably thinking, do I need to be a great writer? And I'm here to tell you, no, you don't. One of the things you can do is get into fiction writing, but that is only one of the things. I've got 9 more ideas that I know you're going to love, and you'll be surprised at what you can actually do from home. So head over there now, download the free report, give it a go, and let me know how you get on with it. So as always, thanks for sharing your time again today. Take care. Have a great day. Bye-bye.